Many public school students headed back to class today at the state's largest high school. The incoming class of freshmen is larger than some schools' entire student body. Campbell High School in Eva Beach welcomed 833 freshmen today. One teacher told us he recently taught a class filled with 52 students. We wanted to know how the school is handling such a large student body and if education officials are looking for solutions. Christina Weno is getting answers. Chris?
Joe, the principal and teachers told me it takes a lot of creativity to handle such a large number of students, and there is a plan to expand the campus.
It's the back-to-school assembly at Campbell High School. But this isn't the entire student body. This is just the freshmen.
What is the biggest class size you've ever had?
52.
52 students in one class?
In one class.
And what are the challenges in trying to capture and hold their attention?
It's very difficult. I can turn around and help one student, and all hell will break loose behind me.
That requires creativity from guidance teacher Justin De Los Reyes.
Sometimes I would partner students with that were higher level with lower level students so they could help me with the instruction.
De Los Reyes doesn't always have enough computers for students, so sometimes they need to take turns. He doesn't always have enough seats either, so that means taking chairs from other classes or even other campuses.
What are some of the other strategies that your teachers are using?
Project-based learning is something that's been fantastic for us, making sure that students are invested and interested in what they're learning.
More than 3,000 students are enrolled here at Campbell High School, and school officials expect that number to grow, since they say developers continue to build in this area.
What is the department doing to help alleviate some of these crowded schools?
Okay, well, currently for Campbell High School, we have done studies of the campus, and we have two locations that are viable to build a building on.
Heidi Armstrong serves as the complex area superintendent. I found out there was money in the Department of Education's budget for a new three-story building at Campbell, which would cost at least $30 million. But Armstrong said the legislature did not fund it.
So while we can plan and design all we want, we can't actually do any building until we get the money.
We need to increase funding for our schools. We need to give our keiki the schools they deserve.
School officials say a new building would help the crowded campus. In the meantime, they continue the best they can.
Despite our size of our student body, you know, we've excelled in numerous areas, whether it's been athletics or academics.
I will follow up with lawmakers to find out why that new building was not funded and if it could be next year. I'll let you know what they say. Christine Ueno, KHON2 News.